Good afternoon, ladies.
Hey, Maria.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hope everyone is well.
Hello.
Listen, we cannot believe that we are finally here at the very end of a long road and season. So we want to thank you and welcome you to the CFC Mississippi Delta Gulf Coastal Plains Thank You Celebration. That's our full government name. We never use it, right? So I'm one of your co-hosts. I'm Pamela Wood. If you haven't seen me all season, where have you been? I'm so glad to meet you. This is my lovely co-host, Melanie Holden. Say hey, Melanie, to the folks. We're going to start it off, as we always do, giving thanks. So we want to thank all of our federal donors to our campaigns that you yourselves brought along by spreading the word. So as you can see, there's a panorama of different agencies throughout the federal ecosystem who contributed to this year's campaign. And for that, we absolutely thank you. Melanie?
Definitely, as Pamela said, today is all about thanking you. And so we are going to be doing some thanking and some recognizing. Pamela and I, we put on we took off the t-shirts. We've been wearing t-shirts all season long. So today we got dressed up for you and we want to thank you. And we ask you to stay till the end because we have a special performance that you don't want to miss. And it has truly been an honor supporting, assisting, and cheering you on all season long. And so as we wrap up this 2020 season and say thank you, we want to bring you, actually, if you've been following us all season, you know we've been doing In the Zone reports, and we thought it was fitting to bring you this final In the Zone 2020 report. And so let's get started putting up our In the Zone scoreboard for the last time this season. Now, as you know, the CFC started nearly 60 years ago to give federal workers and retirees an opportunity to give to charitable organizations in an organized, systemized manner. And that's where the birth of the CFC came about. And we are so happy to say that while we're waiting on the 2020 numbers, the final CFC numbers, we are on track this season alone, over all 36 zones, to exceed $80 million this year alone. And that is amazing. And so of that amount in our Mississippi Delta zone, we have over 1,000 of you, 1,746 federal workers, retirees, contractors, have pledged support to over 800 charities in a local area and across the world. And so 841 charities are going to benefit from your dollars in our Mississippi Delta Zone 20. And are you ready for the final amount? Pamela, let's get that drum roll. Here it is, everyone. You raised $1,066,963 and counting, because we're still they're still processing paper pledge forms. And so we are so excited. Way to go, Mississippi Delta. We are so happy about that. And we've been promising you all season long that at the end, we're gonna have a celebration. And that's what today is all about. It's about celebrating you and your love that you're providing to our charities. And you know how we do it in Mississippi. We're glad some of you already have your cameras on. So now we invite the rest of you who are hiding with your cameras off to turn your cameras on, because you know how we do it. We have the balloons. And now it's time for our 60-second dance party. Everybody, come on, turn your cameras on and dance with us for the next 60 seconds. Come on, Mississippi. Roll call. That's it. Come on now. Louisiana, we know you're in the house. Yes. Yes. gotta be dancing your seat.
Roll call.
Right.
We go celebrate.
Everybody's camera shy.
It's time to come together. It's up to you. What's your pleasure?
Yay. Good job, everybody. We are so happy about raising $1 million for our charities. So that's what's up, and that's why we are here today.
Yes.
So we want to kick things off with a special message from our regional director, Lana Bernard.
Hello. Thank you so much for joining us here today. My name is Lana Bernard, and I'm the regional director for the Mississippi Delta Gulf Coastal Plains Outreach Team. It is with great pleasure that I announce that we have raised over $1 million for our charity so far this year. We couldn't have done this without all the amazing leadership and volunteers, and I thank each and every one of you. I also am bringing greetings from our local Federal Coordinating Committee, or LFCC. The LFCC is a group of federal volunteers that provides leadership and oversight to the campaign. We were so honored to be chaired this year by Cynthia Wallace with the IRS. It is also such a thrill to say thank you and congratulate our two loaned executives this year, Maria Williams and Laura Davis. Loaned executives are federal employees who are reassigned part-time or full-time from their regular duties to work on the CFC campaign. Maria and Laura were just amazing and made such a difference to this year. So if any of you have any interest in serving as an LFCC member or as a loaned executive in the 2021 campaign, please reach out to us at support@msdeltacfc.org and we can connect you to the right people. Again, congratulations and thank you to all of our finalists and winners today. Okay. Back to you, Melanie and Pamela.
All right. Thank you, Lana. We appreciate that. And as we said, today is a day of thanks. So thank you. And it's also a day of recognition. And so right now, we're going to go into the recognition portion of today's celebration. Last month, we asked you to provide nominations for the following award categories: the Ben Franklin Award, the Show Must Go On Award, the Beanstalk Award, the Atlas Award, and Agency of the Year. Now, our Mississippi Delta LFCC Board has received and reviewed all of the nominations and they voted. And so are you ready to hear the finalists and the winners? You think they're ready, Pamela?
I know they're ready.
Okay, so let's get started. Our first category is the Ben Franklin Award. Now, this award is all about innovation. And so, you know, this was a season like no other. Why? Because we're in a pandemic. And so in a pandemic, you had to think outside the box in terms of promoting the CFC. You had some of you had offices and your members were working virtually. And we know, we understand. And we want to recognize some of our agencies that did. They were creative, thinking outside the box and promoting the CFC. And so we're going to start with our finalist for agencies with fewer than 500 employees for the Ben Franklin Award. First up is the Office of Medicare Hearings and Appeals in New Orleans, led by the team of Ariel Berg, Kiera Brown, and Ashley Randall Robinson. We also have the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Memphis office, led by Brenda Barber. And we also have the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers out in Mississippi. Tim, I see you. Led by Tim Black. And let's see. Do we have anything you got an envelope coming up?
Okay. I finally brought the award through.
There we go.
And the winner is the Office of Medicare Hearings and Appeals, New Orleans. Yes. Congratulations.
Congratulations to everyone and congratulations, team.
Mm-hmm. It was a tough category.
It was. They all were. They were all tough categories. Let's see. Now, going for our agencies with more than 500 employees, here are the finalists. Southeast Louisiana Veterans Healthcare System, led by Nathan Fedora and Sheila Addison. And our Postal Service in Louisiana, led by Renette Dominic. Okay, another envelope.
Thanks for sending the envelope. And the winner is the U.S. Postal Service, Louisiana. Okay, we know they were working it off too.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Now we're going to move on to our show Must Go On. Again, this year was all about innovation. And this is in terms of having events, whether you had to be creative and come up with some fun virtual events, or whether you had to, you know, make sure that you followed all the protocols for having a safe, socially distanced in-person event. We thank every campaign manager and key worker and all you teams out there. Now, our finalists for the award category are for agencies with 500 or less employees. We have the Tennessee Postal Service Vehicle Maintenance Department, led by Cassandra Gleason. We have ARS Southern Regional Research Center, led by Matt Labar and Scott Pelletier. And we have our New Orleans Field Office, U.S. Customs and Border Protection, led by the team of Vanessa Vargas, Dion Lane, and Elizabeth Tanner. Yep, there's the envelope.
Here's the envelope. Oh my goodness. I don't know. The winner is ARS Southern Regional Research Center of the USDA. Way to go.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Also, for agencies 500 and above, the finalists for Show Must Go On, the Naval Oceanographic Office out at Nassau Stennis, led by Christian Shelley and team. Fort Polk, Louisiana, led by Roy Mosby and team. And finally, our Veterans Healthcare System of the Ozarks out in Arkansas, led by Alan Wiedekin, Patrick Quinlan, and Cindy Dudley.
Okay. And thanks for the envelope. Let's see. Our winners are the Naval Oceanographic Office, Nassau Stennis. Okay, way to go. Yes.
Congratulations. Thank you to everyone.
So, let's get to the next category, the Beanstalk Awards. Now, this goes for agencies and installations that have demonstrated exceptional growth based on their 2020 campaign results in comparison to 2019 results. Let's take a look at the finalists. First up in the category of less than 500 employees, the FBI, the Little Rock Field Office, led by Josh Pullen and Ashley Hutton. Tennessee Valley Authority, Suzanne Bowman and her team.
All right. Ooh. Oh, look who's made it over to my side of town now.
I was concerned.
Well, thank you. And the winner of the Beanstalk Award is, yay, the FBI Little Rock Office. Congratulations.
Congratulations. Let's see.
Now, keeping it moving.
Because that's how award shows go. We felt that there was another organization during the campaign time that really, really didn't need to be left out in this category. So we have an honorable mention for the Beanstalk Award in agencies less than 500 employees. What does that envelope say?
We have an agency that actually had a 900% increase over their 2019 pledges. And that agency is the Risk Management Agency in Jackson, Mississippi, the regional office led by campaign team Helen Ward and Kamika Gray. Congratulations. We had to make sure that you got a mention. So thank you. Thank you for your work.
Yes. So let's move on to the next. Beanstalk Award, more than 500 employees in the agency. Start off with our first finalist, Space and Naval Warfare Systems Command. You've got James Horde, Kenneth Coleman, Thomas Grauman, Wayne Hill, Preston Smith, Donald Yates, April Williams, Alex Lopresto, Yasmin McMillan, and Demetrius Holiday.
Big team.
Yeah. James Horde was working that.
Mm-hmm.
United States Post Office, Mississippi District, our shy Angela Atkins, I saw your thing in the chat, Angela.
We're working it.
So who won, Melanie? Oh, but wait a minute. I got one more person. I got the Memphis IRS.
Candy, yeah. Willie, and team out. That's right.
Willie Manuel. Sorry about that.
All right. Well, and the envelope has arrived with our winner. Drum roll. Here we have Beanstalk Award for 500 or more. We have the United States Postal Service out in Mississippi. Angela and team, congratulations for your growth over the season.
Yes. Way to grow.
That's it.
So the next category is the Atlas Awards. Now, this is for individuals who implemented a successful CFC and went above and beyond the call of duty and service to the campaign. We consider you all our agency CFC heroes. Mm-hmm. Let's take a look at those finalists, Melanie.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So we've got Marthena Moffitt out in Mississippi Gulf Coast Veterans Healthcare Systems. We've got the Central Arkansas VHA, Fatima Carmichael, Grace Johnson, Weona Brown, Melanie Sabick, Janet Williams-Smith. Now who is gonna win? And we've got Maria Williams, our LE here for the IRS in Louisiana.
So many nominations, so many nominations. Okay, awards girl. All right, thank you for the envelope. Here we have. And our winner, everyone, is all right, Marthena Moffitt and her team out of Mississippi Gulf Coast Veterans Healthcare System. Thank you. Now, I got something else in this envelope, though.
What is it?
Because we had so much going on in this category and nominations. And that one team, we had five nominees in one team. And when we looked at the reasoning and the LFCC examined all of the support that those team members did, we together agreed that there needed to be a special Show Some Love Team Spirit Award for the Central Arkansas Veterans Healthcare Team. And so, way to grow, show, and work together. Congratulations, team. So all of you out at Central Arkansas VA together can share that Team Spirit Show Some Love Award.
And the next category, yes. Agency of the Year. Now, this is the agency that achieved outstanding CFC results by utilizing innovative, creative campaign materials and methods, motivating campaign workers, just creating total awareness overall of the CFC and demonstrating leadership support. Hit me with those finalist names, Melanie.
All righty, we've got to see them.
So, Agency of the Year, less than 500 employees, the Department of Energy, Strategic Petroleum Reserves, New Orleans, and U.S. Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, Memphis District Office.
Okay, thank you.
I'm like this.
Are you ready? Let's see. Ooh. Agency of the Year for 500 employees or less this year is...
Pull those curtains back.
The U.S. Equal Employment Opportunity Commission out in Memphis. Yay, congratulations. These categories were really so tough. Congratulations to everyone, but thank you. Thank you for the nominations and the winners. Yeah. And here we go.
Okay. Next up, Agency of the Year, more than 500 employees. First finalist, Central Arkansas Veterans Healthcare System. Followed by Memphis IRS.
And oops, we're going quick. Hey, that winner wants to be known. Central Arkansas, this was just so close, both of them. We just thank you all, but Central Arkansas, round of applause for you as Agency of the Year 2020. We can't wait to see who our winners are for 2021. So congratulations to everyone. Now, We had some other people that we needed to quickly recognize because, you know, we had that our in the zone report all year long. Well, some of you who weren't on campaign teams wouldn't know this, but Pamela and I were giving challenges out to people all season long, and we were sending out these top five things for campaign managers to do. And so we were challenging them so we could give them weekly shout outs. And we had a certain new campaign manager, first time as a campaign manager, who not only attended all of the trainings and events, but really showed up and had just an off the chart energy and support of the CFC. And again, participation in so many events. What else do you want to say about her, Pamela?
Oh my gosh, this one individual really kept her finger on the pulse of what was happening throughout the campaign. And she let us know through text, through call, through email. We enjoyed her. We would say, did you hear from so-and-so today? Yes. No, I didn't. Maybe tomorrow. And sure enough, there she was. So we just wanted to give this round to it spirit award just for the soul she brought to the campaign. Yes. Pull those curtains back. Who is it?
Come on.
Is it? It's Robbie Julian, U.S. Department of Energy Strategic Petroleum Reserves. Congrats, Robbie.
Always an encouraging voice and a smiling face. So thank you. Thank you. And we do have one other special award that we're calling the Show Some Love Spirit of Excellence Award. And this special recognition is going to a certain someone for their just nonstop CFC support and dedication this 2020 season. She was always making a positive contribution and definitely had an amazing impact on the Mississippi Delta outreach team ourselves. She helped us right alongside. So we could not go without giving an award to none other than our own loan executive for 2020, full-time loan executive, Maria Williams. Yay! Congratulations, Maria. AKA Superwoman, there she is, giving away, and we're blowing a kiss back to you too. Thank you so much for all that you did. And as Lana said, if you're interested in being a loan executive for 2021, email us at support@msdeltacfc.org. We do have 2021 loan executives. Thank you, Maria. Like I said, Wonder Woman, keep it up.
Wonder Woman, for sure.
All right, everyone, listen, congratulations to everyone, not just our finalists and our winners, but everyone who had anything to do with this year's campaign, from all of our agency leadership to campaign managers, key workers, contractors, retirees, everyone. It's because of your efforts that honestly, the true winners are the 848 charities that you all are supporting with your dollars and your time, as well as all of the populations that they serve. We're really putting the dollars in the hands that need it the most. And while we aren't able to provide an award to all of you and all the many deserving agencies this year and your teams for 2020, we want to thank you, and your thank you certificates are on the way. So be on the lookout for those. And now, as our celebration draws close to an end, on behalf of our entire Mississippi Delta outreach team, Lana, Pamela, myself, and Paige, who we want to take a special second to say, we're not going to make you put your camera on, Paige, but Paige is our kind of behind the scenes support person, campaign support specialist who kept us on track all season long. She organized all the lunch and learns, the charity fairs, helped doing newsletters, ran our social media. I mean, truly everyone. Paige Farmer, we love you, Paige. Thank you, thank you, thank you for everything that you did. She told us that she didn't want to put her camera on, but she's listening and she's actually running background for us today on this thank you celebration. So thank you, Paige, on the team. But on behalf of our whole outreach team, Mississippi Delta, we just want to thank you. Yeah. And we appreciate it. It's been an honor, again, supporting, assisting, cheering you on, and just this thank you celebration is all about you. So we want to thank you. And Pamela, what do we have right now?
Well, we've been saying from the beginning, it has been a CFC season like no other. And you rose to the occasion. You made us rise even further to the occasion. And so we want to send you a special CFC 2020 tribute. Within the ranks of our Region 20 in federal agency, I want you to really grasp that. These are your fellow federal coworkers. We've got Maurice Gordon, Zach Bridges of Mississippi Veterans Health Hospital, singing Put a Little Love in Your Heart. Here's the extra added bonus. Zach Bridges is a 2019 finalist on The Voice.
Who knew?
Okay. Yes. We don't skimp on the production around here. I just want you all to be fully aware. Okay.
Yeah.
Melanie.
And before we get it started, I want to say thank you, Mary Magruder, for coordinating all that. Mary, she helped connect us with Zach and Maurice, and thank you. So sit back, guys, and enjoy this CFC tribute.
Think of your fellow man and him a helping hand. Put a little love in your heart. If you see it's getting late, oh, please don't hesitate. Put a little love in your heart, and the world will be a better place. And the world will be a better place for you and me. Just wait and see. Another day goes by, still the children cry. Put a little love in your heart. If you want the world to know, we won't let hatred grow. Put a little love in your heart, and the world
was. Thank you. And I think Zach and Maurice are on, and we appreciate you again for the beautiful song.
Yes.
And just so everyone will know too, that this will be posted a video onto our YouTube as well as our Facebook afterwards. So if you have coworkers who missed that amazing performance, please share it with them as well. And as we get ready to sign off, we say again, congratulations on raising over $1 million for charities. We thank you for your support, for your love, for showing the love to us and being so kind as an amazing zone, and for showing love to our charities this season. So we sign off, but we don't say goodbye. We just say we will see you next season, because in the next few months, we will be starting up. So right now, keep the momentum going. Start organizing your campaign teams right now for the 2021 season. And in the fall, we will reconnect. Make sure, as Pamela said, when we start calling, emailing you in the fall, pick up the phone. Don't act like you don't know us anymore after this season. Yeah. All right, so
you know this voice. Mm-hmm. You know Coach Mel has the whistle. It'll be back next season, okay?
We will. Thank you all so much today for joining us. We appreciate your time. We want to keep the party going and the momentum going. And again, we will see you next season. So we're going to dance our way out of here, everybody.
Dance our way out, guys.
Bye.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, ladies. Awesome campaign. Awesome job.
Congratulations. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. All the comments in the chat. Absolutely.
Oh, wait, I need to see.
Oh, you got to put your glasses back on.
I put your glasses back on.
I dropped mine.
You guys enjoyed it.
Hi, everybody. Have a great rest of the day. We will see you next season.